walking through the cemetery and you can see these huge, really intricate mausoleums, and you have to think that you gotta have some money to be building these things. When you think of cemeteries, you think of people dying of old age. And at this cemetery, there's one thing that most of these people have in common. They're men and they're young. If you look at the years that they were born, this guy 1983, this guy 1981, over here 1980. It doesn't seem to stop. You can see all of these graves just ready for another killing, these men behind me building mausoleums. Right here you can see this young man, Lupito, and up in the corner, an AK-47. So there have been more than 1,000 murders this past year in Sinaloa. How many, out of that 1,000, how many of those murders have been solved?
Ninguno. De esos 1,060, 1,070 asesinatos, ninguno de los que está relacionado con narcotráfico se ha aclarado, ni uno solo.
At the morgue in Culiacan, I met a criminalist who gathers evidence to help solve the murders. So you are a criminalist here in Sinaloa. It's been a very violent year, not just here, but in all of Mexico. Has that made your job difficult?
Hoy se estamos viendo un poquito más de violencia, un poquito más fuerte la cuestión de privarse de la vida.
What are some of the ways in which people are being killed? What are the methods being used?
Ahora lo que ha diferenciado es que ahora tenemos muertes colectivas, que tenemos de 3, 4, 5 cadáveres en un solo hecho. Pues llámese de arma de fuego, gente que ha sido decapitada, gente que ha sido mutilada de alguna parte de su cuerpo.
Vamos a un evento.
¿Qué pasó?
¿Trae la dirección?
Una pena, ¿no?
So we were literally just conducting an interview with a criminalist on the forensics team here, and he came out and he said there's a shooting, so we're gonna follow that team to the site.
My parents live in that neighborhood. So it's pretty scary always, because you're always thinking might be one of your friends, or you might know that person. You never know. You never know what you're gonna get. Yeah, that's the way it is.
We arrived at the crime scene just as the forensics team was walking in. A doctor had been shot by two guys with assault rifles who stormed his office and gunned him down. Is this just normal? You just see, you've just been...
Es normal ver ese tipo de cosas aquí.
Por supuesto, es lo más normal. Él fue bien, fue uno. Aquí matan por puño.
That's his daughter.
It's his daughter?
Yeah.
That's his wife, and the daughter's in the car. Disturbing to think that this scene happens here every day, multiple times a day. Among all the different cartels, who is winning?
Nadie. Nadie está ganando la guerra. Es una guerra de baja intensidad. digo, comparada con otras guerras, no se van a hacer, puede pasar una década y van a sobrevivir los cárteles. Son demasiado fuertes sus estructuras, no se van a hacer daño, digo, van a seguirse matando, pero las estructuras van a permanecer.
So Miguel, what are you hearing?
Someone, a friend of mine, the contact, he just called me. There is a shooting right now going on about outside a supermarket, about 2 miles from here. And there is two dead bodies over there.
Mitch, come here. Do you see the shell casings right here? Right here, you can see the bullet casings right here. They're all over. Let's go around this way.
Okay.
Hurry before they close the line. Oh my God! Oh my God! Oh my God!
Allá afuera, trae el cordón, por favor, oiga, por favor.
Oh my God!
Hágame el favor, hija, por favor. Allá afuera, por favor, ya. Jefe.
Did you see that?
Allá afuera, por favor.
Oh my God!
Allá afuera el cordón, por favor.
Whoa. So you could see that. So you can just see that there were two people in the car and they were just mutilated.
She's crying. That's her son. That's her son. Leave me alone. That's my son. His cousin, the killers.
She's cursing the killers.
The killers, I curse the killers, wherever they are, why you stole this from me, why?
Even though a couple people were just murdered in this parking lot, the supermarket is still open and people are still doing their grocery shopping. Do you think that things will get better? Do you have hope?
No.
No creo, y menos aquí en Culiacán.
There's another shooting right now.
There's another shooting right now?
The other side of the other part of town. It's one dead person.
Another person is dead in another part of town.
Yeah.
But we'd seen enough and couldn't rush off to one more murder in a country where killings have become just a normal part of life.